After studying this module, we shall be able to describe the concept and need for marketing organization, identify the factors that affect a marketing organization, know and choose from the different types of marketing organization structures, describe the concept of marketing control, state the marketing control process, and understand the concept of marketing audit.
Marketing organization is the foundation of effective sales planning and sales policies. It enables systematic execution of plans, policies, programs for controlling all sales activities in order to achieve maximum efficiency, profitability without sacrificing the level of customer services and satisfaction. The need for improved methods of distribution and to keep pace with the expanding production capacity and competition has made sales administration and marketing management one of the most important functions of business. In an organization, the sales planning and sales policies are formulated on the basis of marketing organization. It ensures the smooth and systematic implementation of plans, policies, and programs which are much needed for the control of sales activities so as to maximize the efficiency and profitability. It also brings about innovative and better methods of distribution and helps to meet the increasing production capacity. It also equips the organization with the necessary tools to counteract competition. Marketing organization structures the organization in such a way that brings about improvement in customer services and their satisfaction. Marketing organization is a group of marketing persons brought together to make decisions on the marketing areas like product, price, place, and promotion. Marketing organization is the foundation of effective sales planning for systematic execution of plans and policies. Marketing organization provides a system of relationships among various marketing functions to be performed by proper coordination among marketing persons. In the market where consumer is the king, we need to satisfy the consumer. So, a good marketing operation is required. Marketing organization is the pillar for success of any organizations and provides a framework for the following. First, to divide and fix authority among the subordinates. To locate responsibility, to establish sales routines, to enforce proper supervision of sales force, to avoid repetitive duties, to enable the top executives to devote more time for planning policy matters, and the need for the organization.
A marketing organization can be defined as a framework for planning and making marketing decisions that are essential to the marketing success of a company. It provides the platform for making decisions on all marketing areas such as product, price, place, and promotion. Marketing organization is a group of marketing persons working together towards the attainment of certain common objectives. In today's competitive marketing world, the consumer is the king and rules the market. To become competitive in the market area, we need to satisfy the consumer. Marketing organization is the pillar for success for many organizations and provides a framework for the following. Divide and fix authority among the subordinates, to locate responsibility, to establish sales routines, to enforce proper supervision of sales force, to avoid repetitive duties, and to enable the top executives to devote more time for planning policy matters. Factors influencing a marketing organization can be categorized into two categories, internal and external. Internal factors include top management philosophy, Organizational planning and its working is greatly influenced by the philosophy of the top management, which can be good or bad. For example, centralization versus decentralization. Product policy. The size of an organization is determined on the basis of the width of its product line. As with the size, the product offerings becomes increasingly diverse. For example, there could be a need to move away from straight functional approach to product group approach. People. The size of the organization is more important with respect to human values factor as compared to the number of people. Human values are critical, and correct decisions regarding people cannot be made unless we take into consideration factors such as number, qualifications, capabilities, personality, attitude, fear, suspicion, and ambition. External factors include business environment. Business environment is where an organization functions. With regards to business environment, the following 3 points are important. The type of environment in which the firm is operating, the nature of particular requirement for success, and the rate at which the industry is changing. Markets. The market factor affects the marketing organization to a great extent. The various aspects of a market, such as its size, scope, nature, and location, required to design the size of the organization. External factors include consumer requirements and expectations. Consumers have their own set of requirements and expectations from the organization. The more varied and vivid services they expect, the usual requirements. As a marketer, we need to increase the workload depending upon the consumer requirements and expectations. Channels of distribution. It is a type of channel of distribution which a marketing firm selects based on its size. For example, in case the company opts for indirect channel or channels, it depends on outside sales force and hence the organization gets thinner. When the organization selects direct channel, its size is increased as it has its own sales force. The marketing organization of a business can be structured on any of the following basis: line and staff organization, functional organization, product-oriented marketing organization, customer-oriented marketing organization, geography-oriented marketing organization, matrix form or combined base. Line and staff organization. In most business firms, especially medium size, the marketing job is structured around few line functions and few staff functions. That is, major staff functions is organized into separate departments and the line function is responsible for sales department. The required coordination between the line and staff function is managed by the executives at a higher level.
The merits of line and staff organization structure are: it provides expert advice from specialists. It relieves line executives of routine specialized functions. It enables young sales executive to acquire expertise. It helps in achieving effective coordination. It is easy to operate and it is less expensive. The demerits of line and staff organization structure are: it produces confusions arriving from indeterminate authority relationships. It curbs the authority of experts. Too much is expected from executives, and decision making is taken by top management.
Functional organizational structure. Under the organization, the departments are created on the basis of specified functions to be performed, that is, the activities related to marketing, distribution, etc.
The merits of functional organization structure are: division of work based on specialization. It relieves line executives of routine and specialized functions. It promotes application of expert knowledge. It helps to increase overall efficiency. The demerits of functional organization structure are: it leads to complex relationships. It makes coordination ineffective. It promotes centralization. There is a lack of proper coordination, and it results in delay in taking decisions.
Product-oriented marketing organization. Product-oriented marketing organizations are those organizations that produce a wide variety of products and often organize their marketing, training, and promotion with respect to a product.
The merits of product-oriented marketing organizations are: the salesman can render better customer service as they possess good knowledge of product and may have close contacts with customers. It makes individual departments responsible for the promotion of specific products. It also facilitates effective coordination. The demerits of product-oriented marketing organizations are: it increases the employment of a number of managerial personnel. Many salesmen of same enterprise attend same customer, each representing a separate product, which creates confusion in the minds of the customer, and there may be duplication of activities.
Customer-oriented marketing organization. When the customers are the basis that are used for the departmentation of the sales organization, it is called customer-oriented marketing organization. Departmentation by customer may be done in enterprises engaged in providing specialized services to different classes of customers.
The merits of customer-oriented marketing organization are: it takes into account needs of each class of customers. It provides specialization among the enterprise staff. The demerits are: it makes coordination difficult. It may lead to underutilization of resources in same department. There may be duplication of activities. These types of sales organization are not suitable for small enterprises.
Geography or territory-based organization structure. In a territory-oriented market organization, the line executives are given the responsibilities for marketing of various products. The territory managers are given varying nomenclatures like depot manager, district manager, area manager, zonal manager, divisional manager, etc.
The merits of geography / territory-based organization structure. It leads to economy in terms of time and money. It helps in taking knowledge of local customers. It helps in effective control. And the demerits of this type of organization structure are: it requires employment of number of managerial personnel. It dilutes control from headquarters.
Marketing control is concerned with various aspects such as analyzing the performance of marketing decisions, identifying the problem or opportunities, and taking action to take advantage of opportunities and resolving problems. It is considered as an extension or a sequel to marketing planning. In an organization, all managers are required to exercise control over their decisions and marketing operations with special reference to marketing performance, which is measured in terms of market share, sales, and profits. Today's marketing needs to measure the following given factors: market share, sales and profits, marketing effectiveness, customer satisfaction, customer perception of the firm and its brands. There are four types of controls with different objectives and tools and exist with different levels of management. Annual plan control. In an organization, the top or middle level management evaluates actual performance with set targets to analyze differences or gaps. The evaluation tools used include sales analysis, market share analysis, sales and expense ratios, and financial analysis. Profitability control. It is used by marketing department to examine profitability by product, territory, customer segment, and trade channel. Efficiency control. Efficiency control is used to assess the effectiveness of money spent on sales force, advertising, sales promotion and distribution. It is used by both line and staff executives. Strategic control. It is used by the top management to examine whether the firm and its marketing are able to cope with the environment or not. The major tool used for strategic control is marketing audit. Marketing control process includes monitoring, evaluating, and improving the performance in each activity. The various steps in marketing control process are: decide the aspect of marketing operation to be evaluated. The first step in marketing control process is related to decision making about the marketing operation to evaluate. For example, the effectiveness of media for product advertisement, salesperson performance, or performance of company product, etc. Establish measurement criterion. In this stage, performance standards are decided against which actual performance is evaluated. For instance, control salesperson performance in this one can measure new accounts obtained, call frequency ratio, and order per call. Establishing monitoring mechanism. The next step after setting the standards is to develop monitoring mechanism tools like Marketing Information System, MIS. MIS is used to record performance of all marketing areas like monthly sales volume for products for their evaluation thereafter. The next stage is comparing actual results with standards of performance. In this stage, results obtained through monitoring process are compared with pre-established standards of performance. And the last stage is to analyze performance improvement. The performance is analyzed to make improvement decisions if required. If the results or performance are not up to the desired standards, a corrective action is to be taken to enhance the performance levels. For this, performance improvement analysis is to be done. Marketing audit has been defined as a systematic review and appraisal of the basic objectives and policies of marketing function and of the marketing organization methods, procedures, and personnel employed to implement those policies and to achieve those goals. Marketing audit is one of the important tools to assess the effectiveness of different marketing mix elements.
Marketing audit is an analysis, examination, review, or evaluation of marketing activities of a company. It evaluates marketing environment, objectives, plans, policies, and strategies of a company. After evaluation, it identifies various defects, vulnerabilities, deficiencies, problems, and other weaknesses encountered in the company's marketing activities. It suggests measures and/or recommendations to overcome, solve, or remove these limitations. It also seeks out new marketing opportunities for a company. Overall, it tries to enhance or improve the marketing performance of a company. The marketing audit is a fundamental part of the marketing planning process. It is conducted not only at the beginning of the process, but also at a series of points during the implementation of the plan. The marketing audit considers both internal and external influences on marketing planning, as well as a review of the plan itself. Marketing audit is an extensive, systematic, independent, and regular examination process of a company's marketing activities. It is an extensive or comprehensive process because it covers all marketing activities of a company. It is a systematic or methodical process since it strictly follows all involved steps or procedures properly. It is an independent or autonomous process conducted by an external person. This person is not from the marketing department of a company. It is a periodic process because it is conducted continuously after some fixed interval of time. Marketing audit is very beneficial for the success of a company. It examines how well the marketing department of a company works or functions. It compares the marketing plans of a company with its actual marketing performance. It finds out the strengths and weaknesses of a company's product. It suggests measures to remove the product's weaknesses. It guides a company to adapt its marketing strategies with the changing marketing environment. It helps a company to update its marketing strategies and control its marketing expenses. In short, a company cannot survive without conducting a proper marketing audit. The marketing audit focuses on three key headings: the external marketing environment, the internal marketing environment, evaluation on the current marketing plan. The external environment consists of economic, political, and legal factors and concentrates on clients and competition. Marketing audit of the external surroundings analyzes the customers, their needs, and how to meet them, their behavior and decisions, perception of products and brands, segmentation, targeting, and positioning on the market. The nature of competition is also studied, concerning its concentration, profitability, strengths and weaknesses, plans and strategies. New entrants on the market are also studied, as well as the substitute products, the influence of supplier. The cultural nature of the external environment consists of educational level and standards, religion and beliefs, as well as lifestyle and customs. Demography plays a key role in marketing audit of the consumers, reflecting on growth distribution, age, evolution of technology and information systems, as well as marketing communication and media. The external economic conditions consist of indicators as unemployment rates, inflation levels, interest rates, economic growth, taxation and average disposable income. Political and legal landscaping concern laws, regulations, minimum levels of taxes or wages and maximum levels of prices or quotas. Internal environment focuses on the resources the company has at hand. For example, labor, finance, equipment, time and other factors of production. It also analyzes the marketing team concerning structure, efficiency, effectiveness, correlation with internal functions and other organizations. The internal marketing planning process, it is accuracy and actuality. The product portfolio, new products, pricing and distribution are areas the marketing internal audit is concerned in. It also focuses on market share, sales, profit margins, costs, and effectiveness of marketing mix. The marketing audit studies also the current marketing plan, focused on objectives, strategies, and the marketing mix used to achieve these goals. It also evaluates budgeting, staffing, training, developing, experience, and learning. The current marketing plan concerns also the market share, financial targets as profit and margins, cash flow, debt, and other indicators that need to be balanced. There are several approaches that can be used, for example, SWOT analysis for the internal environment as well as the external environment. Other examples include PEST, political, economic, social, technological, and five forces analysis, which focuses solely on the external environment. Using SWOT, a company lists its advantages and disadvantages, strengths and weaknesses compared to its competitors or similar products providers. It also includes an analysis of the external factors that could help or hinder company's chance of success, as well as an evaluation of internal practices and operations.
Features of marketing audit are comprehensive. The term marketing audit should be reserved for comprehensive audit covering the company's marketing environment, objectives, strategies, etc. It should cover horizontal audit. It is a study of overall marketing performance, and vertical audit. It is an in-depth analysis of one aspect of the firm's marketing strategy. Systematic. Marketing audit will normally move to the extent that it follows a sequence of diagnostic steps covering internal and external marketing systems. Independent. Marketing audit can be conducted in different ways, including self-audit, audit from across, audit from above, company auditing office, company task force audit, etc. Periodic. A periodic marketing audit promises the benefits for the companies that are in good state as well as the companies that are in trouble. This has to be done at periodic levels. There are various types of marketing audit used in marketing. Let us study these one by one. Marketing environment audit. Marketing audit has been divided into two groups. One, macro environment, and two, task environment. In macro environment, various macro factors such as political, economic, technological, and cultural aspects are analyzed and audited. Task environment audit covers customers, competitors, markets, dealer distributors, suppliers, marketing firms, and the public. Marketing strategy audit. Marketing strategy audit is used to review a firm's marketing mission, objectives, goals, and strategies, and to assess their compliance to present and future environment. Marketing organization audit. The firm's capability in implementing necessary strategies for the future environment is evaluated under marketing organization audit. It also analyzes formal organization structure and efficiency. Marketing systems audit. Marketing systems evaluates the systems which are parts of another system. The former systems are considered as subsystems of the latter and includes systems such as marketing information system, marketing planning system, marketing control system, and new product development system. Marketing productivity audit. It is important to analyze the profitability of different marketing entities and cost effectiveness of different heads of marketing expenditure. Marketing productivity audit is used to analyze the profitability and cost effectiveness of marketing expenditures made under different heads. Marketing function audit. It is a functional audit broadly covering the various elements of the marketing mix, product, price, place, and promotion, that is advertising, sales promotion, sales force, and publicity.
Let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Marketing organization can be defined as a framework for planning and making marketing decisions that are essential to marketing success. There are various factors affecting the marketing organization, and these have been categorized as internal factors and external factors. Different organizations can have different structures, which can be any one from the following: line and staff organization, functional organization, product-oriented marketing organization, customer-oriented marketing organization, geography-oriented marketing organization, and matrix form or combined base structure. Marketing control is concerned with various aspects such as analyzing the performance of marketing decision, identifying the problem, opportunities, and taking actions to take advantage of opportunities and resolving problems. Also, marketing audit is used as one of the important tools to assess the effectiveness of different marketing mix elements. Thank you.